Wilson Hockey Night in Canada and the Stanley Cup Playoffs. It seems one's the loneliest number whenever the Oilers beat Minnesota. February 20th, they were beaten 5-1 in Bloomington. March the 1st, a one-goal performance was good for a tie at home. But 5 days later at the Met, a one-goal effort fell well short. Thursday night, the Oilers led the Stars by one until Neil Broughton squared the affair. In the middle period, Dave Gagne scored on the power play, giving the Stars a 2-1 advantage. From that point on, the Oilers witnessed a disturbing trend. John Casey was stellar in goal. The Stars extended their lead in the third period on a goal by Gaétan Duchesne. And with the defensive resolve which made Bob Gainey famous, they buried the champs. The Stars win another one, allowing just one in Game 1 at Edmonton.
And Hockey Night in Canada on CBC.
John Muckler's decisions regarding the series deficit won't be panic-driven. The Oilers tread easily when troubled. They beat Calgary after trailing 3-0 in Game 7 on the road. After losing the first game in Los Angeles, overtime heroes Peter Klima and Esa Tiikkanen brought the Oilers back. Tonight, their year of living dangerously stars Minnesota in Game 2 of the Campbell Final.
Tonight's telecast is brought to you by Molson Canadian, what beer is all about. By Ford of Canada, where quality is more than a commitment, quality is job one. By Esso Associates and Imperial Oil, you're on your way with Esso. And by Pepsi, it's got what it takes.
Arriving in Edmonton, they know, and so do the Oilers, they've got to score more. 4 goals in 4 games against the Stars isn't good enough. They'll need offense to even the series in Game 2 of the Campbell Final tonight from Edmonton. Good evening and welcome to Molson Hockey Night in Canada on CBC and the Stanley Cup Playoffs. I'm Ron McLean. The fans of the Oilers hope to generate more pressure here this evening. In the history of hockey, only 6 teams have rallied to win a series after losing 2 games at home. So the law of averages tells the Oilers the pressure is on them. Clearly, the Minnesota North Stars and the Oilers went into Game 1, the first game of the Campbell Conference Final, begging a need to gain some emotion. The feeling in Edmonton was after Calgary and Los Angeles, how could the Oilers be ready? And what with the layoff, it's no doubt the reason they lost that game. But Bobby Clark took exception to that. He said it was no different for the Stars. They'd beaten Chicago and St. Louis. They also had a layoff, and like the Oilers, he expects his club to be better tonight. Now for a player's perspective, Craig McTavish of the Edmonton Oilers is treating tonight as a must-win situation, but doesn't blame the loss 2 nights ago on a faulty effort.
Well, I really...